This is a simple FastAPI endpoint. It makes a HTTP GET request. It uses Python's request library to make the request. The Python code, other than the GET request, takes time of the order of few microseconds. However, a HTTP GET request over the internet takes time of the order of hundreds milliseconds. This endpoint is processed in the event loop. It will block the event loop for say 300 milliseconds. We don't want to do that because we want our application to have high availability. To make a highly available application, we must not block our endpoint for 300 milliseconds. And by using some asynchronous HTTP client, we can avoid this. The Python's request library does not have an asynchronous client, so we have to look for an alternative library. The most natural choice is using httpx library because FastAPI has a dependency on httpx library. And when we install the FastAPI, the httpx library is installed with it. We can import the async client from httpx library. We can start HTTP connection inside asynchronous context manager. This makes sure the HTTP connection is closed after we are done requesting. With the asynchronous client, we can now await the request. That is, we can pause the execution of the coroutine, that is our endpoint, until the request response is ready. So our endpoint is not blocked for 300 milliseconds. Instead, it is available to process other requests. Now let's come to the best practice in using the asynchronous client in FastAPI. It is okay to use this one, that is creating client inside context manager every time you want to make a request. But there are two better approaches. The first one is we can create a dependency which returns the asynchronous client inside our context manager. It saves us some code, that is we no longer need to write the context manager every time we want to use the HTTP client. The dependency takes care of that for us. There is this another approach, and we can create an asynchronous client when our FastAPI app starts up. That is in the lifespan event. We store it in an app state so that we can access it inside any endpoint and close the connection when our application shuts down. This is more efficient than the dependency one, as we are not creating async client instance for each request. But there are some trade-offs, especially when you are making requests to multiple applications on different domains. Like you can't use some client-level features like client-level base URL, headers, etc. You have to specify all that in each request. You can also create separate client for different external APIs if you want to use the client-level features. I think that's it for this video. If you like such best practices videos, consider subscribing, and thank you for watching.